Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and today we're going to look at creating virtual desktops with XenDesktop 5. As always, you can follow these videos on theurbanpenguin.com, and if you're on Twitter you can follow me at The Urban Penguin, and on Facebook the URL is The Urban Penguin. Part of managing Xen App and Xen Desktop is Citrix Access Gateway, and I've recently had a book published if you're interested. So this is where the fun begins with Xen Desktop, when we start to create our virtual machine images. So we're going to install the virtual desktop agent onto a Windows 7 machine, but it could be Windows 7 or Windows XP. Once that has been completed, we're going to use Desktop Studio to create machine catalogs and then desktop groups, and then of course we're going to be able to access our virtual desktops via the web interface site and our Citrix receiver. So the virtual desktop agent is installed onto our master desktop virtual machine. So we're first of all going to install, say, Windows 7 with the associated applications that we want our users to be able to use. Once that's installed and ready to go within our hypervisor environment, we're going to add to it the virtual desktop agent. Once installed, this is going to act as our ICA server to accept incoming ICA requests from the receiver. It will also communicate back to the desktop delivery controllers with its status information. So the ICA port is going to be 1494 or 2598 if we're going to use session reliability. And of course, talking back to the delivery controllers is going to be on TCP port 80. Machine catalogs are there to group machines of certain types together. So we can create a catalog either through the machine node of Desktop Studio or through the machine creation wizard in Desktop Studio. Here we point to our master image and we specify how many copies we want to make from it, and we'll duplicate that master image. We don't have to worry about sysprep or joining the machines to the domain. They're automatically added to the domain and there is no need with Xen Desktop to run sysprep. It's all part of the process. Our desktop groups then act as our assignments, so we can access this through the assignment node or through the user assignment wizard in Desktop Studio to create our first desktop group. The group then will pull machines from a catalog and make them available to users. So let's get into the demonstrations. So starting off on my Windows 7 machine that is already domain joined and I've logged on as a domain administrative account, put in the Xen Desktop 5.6 DVD and we can see the auto select program should run. From here, obviously, we can then select to install the virtual desktop agent, which is going to essentially make this our ICA server for incoming connections from clients. So as this is a desktop, we can only install the desktop agent. We can't install the server components. So install Xen Desktop is only available on our servers and install virtual desktop agent is only available on our XP and Windows 7 machines. The quick deploy is what we looked at before with our proof of concept system. Now we want to specify where our controllers are, so we use the advanced deploy. Of course, we read the licensing agreement very carefully before we accept. And we can choose with Xen Desktop 5.6 to install the virtual desktop agent, or if we have the registration keys for virtual desktop agent and the 3D Pro graphics card, we can use enhanced 3D graphics. That's only available for 5.6, so if you're studying for your ordinary CCA 5, you won't be tested on the HDX 3D Pro. So choosing next will then take us into what components we want to install. The VDA is required and is grayed out, but we could additionally install the Citrix receiver. This would allow us, if we want to access hosted applications on our Xen App servers. We're not using Xen App in this instance, so we'll jump through that. Personal VDisk again is new to Xen Desktop 5.6 and wouldn't be part of your CCA 5 topics. We will look at this later, but for the moment we're not going to enable in this master image personal VDisk support. We'll keep it just to the exam. Now we've got to enter the address of the controllers, and this is just a space separated list, but it has to be their DNS names. Or we could select from groups within the Active Directory, or configure later through policies, but then we would have to create a group policy to specify where our controllers are. So we'll go through and specify the controller that I'm using, and we can check that we can resolve the name. And then moving through, we can look at this virtual desktop configuration. So we're going to open up the ports 80, 40, 94 and 25, 98. So that's going to be our ICA ports, session reliability ports, and the port 80 for communication back to the controllers. Optimize then desktop performance. So just do some Windows 7 tweaks. Enable port 3389 for remote assistance, so that's what we call desktop shadowing, but it just uses Microsoft remote assistance. Enable WinRM for real-time monitoring, and if we want to, we can open up the UDP audio ports. The summary, and then we can get into the installation. So once the install of the virtual desktop agent has completed, you can see from the screen that we require a restart to complete the install. And we should run through this restart, but once it has restarted and we've logged on, we're going to shut the virtual machine down again because we want to then use this for machine creation services to create our target virtual machine from. So we're going to be duplicating this virtual machine. So now connecting back into the machine that runs my desktop delivery controller, and we're going to run the Desktop Studio, the main management tool for XenDesktop. So we wait for the MMC to fire up, accept the UAC warning, and we're going to start looking at creating machine catalogs. We can do that through the machine nodes and moving across on the right to create catalog. But from our main landing page, we can see that we don't currently have any catalogs, and we're able to create catalogs using the machine creation wizard. So moving back then to the Desktop Studio, which is going to give us our main landing page, we can see that our initial site is complete, but we haven't created any machine catalogs yet, so we can use the configure button, and that's going to take me into the create catalog wizard. The catalog then can have different types of machine. The default machine type, as we can see, is machine type of pooled, but we can choose different types of catalogs. As we drop down, we can see that it can be pooled or pooled with personal vDisk. Personal vDisks are only for XenDesktop 5.6, so they don't come into part of your CCA exam, but we will look at them because you're most likely going to be coming across them in your time pretty soon. Could be dedicated machine, where perhaps we're just offering one virtual machine to one user, maybe a specific type of user. Or we might be offering existing machines, so existing virtual machines to our user base. Might even be using physical machines. These might be for remote PCs sat on somebody's desktop, or they might actually be high powered machines for things like AutoCAD and 3D design engineering that are blade PCs in your server rooms. We could also use provisioning services to stream or stream with personal vDisk. We will look at streaming later, as streaming and PVS provisioning services makes up part of your CCA qualification. So we will stick with pool for the moment, but we can also choose random or static assignment of virtual machines, and then we can choose the master image. So we're going to use our Windows 7 32-bit image. Had we already created snapshots of it, we could expand and choose one of the snapshots to use to duplicate. So we're going to create a snapshot, and then we'll duplicate that snapshot, as a snapshot doesn't currently exist. Run through next. Now we're going to be asked how many virtual machines do we want to copy from this. So we'll just say 2, I don't have that many resources. The master image that we're using, and we're creating new accounts in the Active Directory, but we of course have to specify where to create those computer accounts. So on the next tab, we're choosing then our domain, example.local, and we can choose then just the computers folder, or we could choose an additional OU. Now we're going to choose how to name the machines. So we've obviously got to create the machine account and also name the machine. There's no sysprep or anything like that, but we still have to run through a mini setup wizard. We don't see that, but it's then supplied directly through its account information that is stored in its own separate file. So we're going to choose then the naming scheme to be VDAW7 hyphen followed by one number. That number is going to be 0 through to 9, but we could also use letters. So we can see then a sample underneath of how the first machine is going to appear. We can assign administrators. Currently we only have full administrators, we don't have any catalog administrators, so we will stick with just the full administrators here. And we can set up a description so the administrators know what this catalog is all about. So we can put in whatever we want, so Windows 7, SPE1, 32-bit. Choose next, we get to see the summary and set a main catalog name. So then the process will go through creating the catalog, creating the snapshot, and then copying the master image. It's really copying of the master image that takes the time. It doesn't really matter how many images we're creating, they all use the one master image. What really takes the time is copying that 20 gigs of information, or however much information you have in your Windows 7 image, across to the master image. But then once it has completed, it will close and open up the landing page, and we can see now that the initial configuration is complete. We've gone through and created our first catalog, so machine creation is complete. We now need to go through our user assignment, or create desktop groups. We can do that through the user assignment wizard, or we can go through to the assignment and create a new desktop group. But before we do that, let's jump into the Citrix Zen server management tool and take a look at the virtual machines that have been created. So we can see here's my master image that we worked from, and here is our catalog. So we created then a snapshot, and then we duplicated this snapshot to make our catalog. We can see the machines below, so the VDA Win71 and VDAW72, they are the virtual machines that have been duplicated from this master image. So back in Desktop Studio, we're going to use the user assignment wizard and click configure, and then it's going to take us through creation of a desktop group. So the first thing is to choose which catalog we want to use. Obviously we've only got one, and we can use two machines from that catalog, and we've only got two available. We can have multiple groups feeding from the one catalog if we've got enough virtual machines. The catalog is really describing the machines, the group is assigning them to the users. We can then choose the users. We can specify how many machines that they should have each. And then when we're adding in, we're going to assign it through to domain users. And then continue. And we don't have any additional administrators at the moment, so we can only use our full administrators. Running through next, we can set a display name, and this is important for the users, and then set up a name that administrators will see for the group underneath the assignments node. So once we're finished with that, of course our landing page now is complete. We've got a catalog, we've got groups, all of that has been set up. So all that's left us now is to go to the site dashboard, and that will open up, if you like, the main summary page of what we have in our Zen Desktop 5, or in our case 5.6 site. So we can review what we've done by looking at this summary page. So it shows us how many machines that we've got. So we've got two in total. Then we can see the desktop groups that we've got. So we've got two machines in desktop groups, and they're not turned on, although one will be turning on any moment now, I feel. We can go through to the machine node, and we can see the machines that we have got, so their catalogs, and how many are assigned through groups. And we can move down to the assignments node to see our desktop groups. And again, here we can see how many are connected, how many are registered, how many are available. So if we move back down now into the Zen Center management tool. So we can see now one of the virtual machines has turned on for VDAW7-1. And I've got another one that's not turned on at the moment. It's still, of course, available. It's just not powered on. Until somebody connects to the first machine, there's no need to start the second machine. And we can see we have a differencing disk. This stores the temporary information while the machine is powered on. And then the identity disk that holds the machine's identity, the machine name, and all of the Active Directory credentials that it needs. So returning to my client machine, I can fire up the browser and visit the web interface site. So I happen to be using the web interface server as my client. So I can then browse through to the localhost and put in my credentials. So we're logging into the web interface server. This is the web interface 5.4. And now we can see my Win7 desktop resource. Clicking on it is going to launch the ICA file and give me a connection to the desktop. We can see that we fire up the desktop viewer. Remember, in the webinterface.conf, we enabled the desktop viewer. So show desktop viewer equals on. And then we maintain then the ICA connection through to the desktop, and we can see it's logging in then as my user account. So I've logged into the web interface as Andrew, and it's logging me in as Andrew to the Windows 7 device. And we can see that the machine is domain joined and has the name that we set it. So we didn't have to worry with sysprep or anything like this. The desktop viewer gives me shortcuts through to my Windows keys. So the control delete, we can go into full screen mode, we can disconnect, leave our session running. We can go through into our preferences and choose whatever we want, from our display settings through to our file access settings, to optimizing flash and how we want to deal with our microphone and webcam. Especially important if we're using things such as conferencing technologies such as Microsoft Link Server or something like that. But there we go, there's our Windows 7 desktop that we're able to access pretty much from any device anywhere. And of course, if we want to access the programs, we can, or if we just want to log off, we can log off, so our session then is closed and this virtual machine is put back into the pool. But hopefully you found this as an interesting discussion as to how we can start using virtual desktops within your organization, and a quick introduction to machine catalogs and desktop groups.